Lost in the shuffle of NFL free agency madness is, oh yeah, Danielle Hunter's not really thrilled with his contract as he looks to come back from the hernia disc in his neck that cost him the entire 2020 season. And those seeds were planted a few months ago, like we pointed out, when Rap Sheet tweeted out the announcement about Danielle Hunter's surgery, adding that editorial, oh, Vikings got to trade him or pay him, blah, blah, blah. Clearly a plant from Danielle's agent. Also, Danielle liking tweets about him being traded to the Titans and the Raiders last week. Now, Chad Graff of The Athletic, been doing phenomenal work during free agency, by the way, is reporting that the trade request might be a coming. So he tweeted this out, quote, sources, Danielle Hunter remains unhappy with his current situation with the Vikings as exploring all options, including a trade request. Now, all the options could mean a lot of things. Obviously, yes, formally requesting a trade, putting that out there puts the Vikings on the defensive. Bah. Or, you know, playing games on social media. He only needs to call Stephon Diggs and get tips on that. Or picking an absolute junkyard dog agent, changing things up and bringing in a guy like Rosenhaus and forcing his way out of town. Now, my preference would be to keep Danielle Hunter and pay him. Yes, still major concerns about the neck. Is it going to be the Danielle Hunter before the herniation? But you can protect yourself. Injury guarantees, injury clauses, all of the things. Danielle is only 26 and is one of the best, if not the best, edge rusher in the National Football League. Is also a selfless team-first player against the run, and he's the youngest player ever to 50 sacks, a career 13.44% pressure rate, and he's going to be a first ballot Hall of Famer if he's able to come back at the level that he was at. And he has significantly outperformed his contract. His average was 18th highest in the league in 2020, but yes, we hear all of that. Dur. Danielle signed his contract. Now he has to honor his contract. Well, we hear this a lot. Whenever a player is cut by a team who's underperforming his contract, well, it's a business. It's just a business. But it's a business runs both ways. If it's a business, if a team cuts a player, then it's a business. If a player sees that his market value is significantly higher than what he's currently being paid, and it is the NFL, it is not for long. As Danielle showed, you can be one play, one injury, one practice rep away from the end of your career. You got to get yours while the sun is shining. That's right. Also, dur. He got paid last year for doing nothing. It wasn't like he was sitting on the couch eating bonbons. It wasn't that. He sustained a potentially life-changing injury while practicing to play a game for your entertainment in an industry where the market bore out that his value is tens of millions of dollars. He didn't just walk away to eat ice cream and still got paid. So that's a stupid moronic take. Sorry, it just is. Now, when asked last week if Danielle Hunter or his agent had expressed issues about the problems with his contract, Spielman said no. But Spielman lies like a friggin' rug, so don't believe a word he says. So the Vikings are obviously aware of what is going on here, hence why they're potentially showing interest in defensive ends Trey Hendrickson and Carl Lawson in free agency. But if it really is an untenable situation, and if the Vikings aren't going to budge on money, and Danielle isn't going to budge on, hey, pay me or I want to trade, let's talk turkey. Let's talk about it. Well, definitely want at least two ones and some change. Like, I want at least the Khalil Mack deal. Now, the Vikings may have lost a little bit of leverage here, but that could be made up by a number of teams in on the Derby, driving up that price. But also, it could help that the draft class for Edge is kind of, eh. I mean, you got Pay, you got Disease, you got Rousseau, sure, but is it, like, top heavy? Like, there's no immediate Danielle Hunter in this class. Plus, if Danielle's neck is good to go, you have a potential first ballot Hall of Famer in his prime. It's going to cost you, Chief. So cough it up. We want two high ones and some change. We want two high ones and a starter. We want an extremely high one. Dolphins, get at us with the number three overall pick and change. But it's tough. It is tough because I love Danielle Hunter. I want him back. I want him healthy. I want him pissed off for greatness because I think he certainly is going to be that, putting in that work. And if the Vikings don't get what they want in trade, they can step away. Like, they can play hardball. They can take this thing to the mat with Danielle because he is under contract for three more years. If they want to be the bad guy and if they have to use all the leverage that they have, because they exactly do have that. So, again, all this is hopefully just a ramping up of a cold war. Hopefully it does not turn hot. Again, pay Danielle Hunter. You can protect yourself with injury clauses and guarantees and then just go from there. And guess what? If he outperforms his contract again, pay him. I don't care what it takes. You saw what happened last year when Danielle Hunter went away, when Yannick the freaking Ngakoue went away. The Vikings had one of the worst pass rushes in the NFL, if not the worst. Plus, a guy who's going to be a team first, plays the run, is stout in that left defensive end spot. Come on, fix things. Get this together. But If you do have to trade him, get your pound of flesh. Get all of it. Let's go. Beer thoughts. Danielle Hunter reportedly going to formally request a herd. Let us know in the comment section below. Subscribe for daily Vikings takes. Want to support that work, pull some in the Venmo. But until next time, Skull Production Value.